when you talk about interest rates, who's got the best rate, knowing when to lock your rate, whether it's a good idea to buy your rate down. But first, a very brief history lesson. You know, I began my career as a cortisone officer in Great Western Bank in 1983 after having spent the prior 7 years selling real estate. Believe it or not, three different years rates were hovering 16%. The most popular loan at that time was the most adjustable rate mortgage. That loan was a loan of choice for many people until about 3 years ago, the lender stopped doing it. By the way, those fortunate enough to have kept their adjustable rate loans that are currently under 3% the goal. The crash we experienced recently, and some will argue we're still experiencing, is similar to what happened from 1989 to 1996. Declined about 40% during that time after having shot up in value during the mid-80s. Fixed rates at that time were still about 10%. It wasn't until the mid-90s that they dropped about 7%. So then, well, value shot up again, rates began to decrease, and today rates are as low as they've been in decades. So the big question is, how does one shop for a loan? Well, as you can predict the future, deciding on a rate is really no different. Buying stock or a commodity. That's because mortgage rates are tied to the bond, which goes up and down several times in a day. If the locks rates move downward, you're stuck with your rate locked. On the other hand, if you don't lock, you're selling your rate, and you're most likely to be uncomfortable. Pretty much all lenders charge about a half a point float down fee to renegotiate a lower rate. So, what is my advice? I suggest you pick a lender that you feel comfortable with based on your reputation, making sure that rates and fees are competitive, and then go ahead and lock your rate. Once your rate is locked, it becomes a worst-case scenario. People, as a rule, are much more upset with themselves than letting a rate float when you end up with a higher rate by locking after the rates decrease. Lenders, as a rule, like I said, will allow you to renegotiate your rate by paying a float down fee, but this will be done right before escrow closes, at which time you can decide whether it makes mathematical sense to float the rate down. Another issue to consider is whether to buy your rate down by paying points. To determine whether this makes sense, you need to calculate the difference in payments between 0.10